Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about bicarbonate reabsorption along the nephron. So let's get started. Bicarbonate ions are freely filtered at the glomerulus. Then 80% is reabsorbed from the proximal tubule, 10% from the thick ascending limb, and 10% from the distal tubule and collecting duct. About 0.01% is excreted in urine. Now let's see the mechanism of reabsorption. An interesting thing about bicarbonate reabsorption is that it's not transported. It's teleported. Yes, a molecule of bicarbonate disappears from the tubular lumen and magically appears in the interstitium. So let's see the secret behind this magic. The trick starts with the secretion of hydrogen into the lumen. In the proximal tubule, this occurs mainly by sodium-hydrogen exchanger. Inside the lumen, the hydrogen ion reacts with bicarbonate ion and from carbonic acid. This molecule then dissociates into CO2 and H2O. This dissociation process is very slow. But there is an enzyme on the membrane called carbonic anhydrase 4. It catalyzes this reaction, hence making it fast. Now, the CO2 moves through the cell membrane and enters the cell. Inside the cell, it reacts with a water molecule and forms carbonic acid. This reaction is also slow and is catalyzed by a different type of carbonic anhydrase enzyme called carbonic anhydrase 2. Upon being formed, the carbonic acid undergoes spontaneous dissociation into bicarbonate and hydrogen. Then bicarbonate exits the cell by sodium bicarbonate cotransporter. Hydrogen is again secreted into the tubule, and the entire process is repeated. During each such cycle, one bicarbonate ion disappears from the lumen and appears in the interstitium. This way, the bicarbonate keeps being reabsorbed from the tubule. This basic mechanism of reabsorption is the same in all the segments. The difference is seen only in transporters of hydrogen and bicarbonate. As we have already seen, in the proximal tubule, the hydrogen is transported by sodium-hydrogen exchanger, and bicarbonate moves by sodium bicarbonate cotransporter. In the thick ascending limb, for hydrogen, we again have sodium-hydrogen exchanger. However, the basolateral exit of bicarbonate occurs mainly by the chloride bicarbonate exchanger. Talking about the distal tubule and collecting duct, here the reabsorption occurs by alpha intercalated cells. They have hydrogen pumps at the apical membrane to secrete the hydrogen ions. The basolateral exit of bicarbonate occurs by chloride bicarbonate exchanger, as in thick ascending limb. So this was all about the reabsorption of bicarbonate from the renal tubule. Now before we see the summary, I want to tell you about my website, nonstopneuron.com. It offers easy navigation and a distraction-free environment to explore my entire library of more than 300 animation videos. If you are in the mood for learning, the website is the best place. You can find the link at the end screen and the description. Coming back to the summary, 80% of the filtered bicarbonate is reabsorbed from the proximal tubule, 10% from the thick ascending limb, and 10% from the distal tubule and collecting duct. The process of reabsorption includes the secretion of hydrogen ions into the lumen, conversion of bicarbonate into carbon dioxide, entry of carbon dioxide into the cell, formation of bicarbonate in the cell, and its exit at the basolateral membrane. The overall process is the same in all the segments. The only difference occurs in the exact transport protein involved in the movement of hydrogen and bicarbonate ions. That's all for the reabsorption of bicarbonate along the nephron. For sticking with me until the end, I have a bonus point for you. I said that the kidneys excrete 0.01% of filtered bicarbonate, remember? Based on that, you must be thinking that the bicarbonate leaving the kidneys must be 99.99% of what entered, right? But it's wrong. the amount leaving is actually more than that entered. The reason is that kidneys not only reabsorb almost all of the bicarbonate, but it also generates new ones. So we have more bicarbonate leaving the kidneys than entered. This generation is part of the acid-base balance, so we will study it in more detail in that topic. That's it for this video. If you liked it, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to visit the website, which is the best place to explore my videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.